thank you for joining me again on this session of Sunday Reflection. I look back at my Sunday sermon here at First Assembly of God Church. And the last few weeks, I have been preaching on the final journey to Jerusalem. And last Sunday Reflection, we looked at Luke chapter 18, verses 9 through 14, and the story of the Pharisee and the publican, how the publican, the tax collector, was found worthy of salvation because of his repentance and his humility. And the Pharisee, who was very self-righteous and was found to be really, the Bible says, praying to himself. And it was quite a contrast of the two personalities. You know, the Pharisees was one of the main groups that consented to the death of Jesus. They conspired to kill him, were a part of that process. What went so tragically wrong with the Pharisees? You would think they would be the first to recognize Jesus, a religious group in Israel and so studied in the Old Testament scriptures. How could they miss it? Well, an interesting insight is found in the book of Acts chapter 7, verse 51. When Stephen was stoned by the Sanhedrin, which certainly was made up a great deal of the Pharisees, he told them that they were uncircumcised of heart and that they always resisted the Holy Spirit. Now that is a cutting accusation against the Jewish group, because the uncircumcised of heart, circumcision was the sign that God gave to Abraham that he was with the descendants of Abraham and would distinguish them in the earth. But you know what? Just because they had this outward sign of godliness doesn't mean that in their heart they knew God. And Stephen tells them, you are circumcised in flesh, but in your heart you are uncircumcised. Literally, you do not know God in your heart. And when he said they resisted the Holy Spirit, that's a tremendous statement. Because if we resist the Holy Spirit, literally it means we're resisting God. He is the agent that brings conviction to us. He is the agent that brings the knowledge of sin and of righteousness and brings us to the point of accepting salvation. So when Stephen told them, you're uncircumcised of heart, he said, your heart is wrong. Your spirit is wrong. Your attitude is wrong. You have a religious form, but in your spirit, you are not right with God. So today, I want to ask you, do you have a religious spirit, or do you have a spirit of salvation? Do you have a spirit of a relationship with God, one that is touched by His Spirit? Are you the temple of the Holy Spirit? Are you born again? Has Jesus, by the shedding of His blood and the renewing of the Holy Spirit, cleansed you of your sins? Do you walk in a fresh relationship with God through Jesus Christ? That's where I think we need to be today. We don't need to be a religious person that is caught up in that religious spirit. We need to be a person who has a fresh relationship with God through His Son, Jesus Christ, being the temple of the Holy Spirit. I look forward to being in church with you this coming Sunday. It's Friends and Family Day. I want to encourage you to invite your friends and family to the house of God. I'm looking forward to a very special day. God bless you. Look forward to seeing you Sunday in the house of God. God bless you.